You grew up collecting, trading, and playing with cards, and now you're wondering if you could bring those cards and memories to life. Well, you're in luck, as I was wondering the same. Let's break it down. There are five elements that make this animation. The card, the window, the object, the rotation, and the light. Let's start with the card. It's a rectangle. I draw mine with the rectangle tool in After Effects. Design yours however you like. I made mine similar to the actual physical cards I used in the video. I adjusted the roundness and added texture. Pre-comp the playing card after you're done. After you have your card, it's time to add the window. As I want this part to move, I will separate it to a different composition. So, create a new comp, name it. For my purpose, I want to create a kind of hallway, and the hands are traveling through that hallway. To make it more apparent, I will add textures to the wall. Try different combinations until you find something that works for you. I ended up using this texture from texturelab.org, which I highly recommend. Make the layer 3D and rotate it on the Y axis. Duplicate the layer and flip it horizontally. Play around with the position. To make it move, add the offset effect to it. Make a keyframe and that is it for the window, for now. Okay, let's move to the object. You can choose anything you want, an image, animation, or footage. The animation will move with the card, meaning it will go reverse when the card spins back again. So creating animations that play well with reversing their speed is better. I already animated this sun emoji that's been lying around on my hard drive, taking up space, doing nothing. Until now, it's your time to shine, sun. New comp, name it window object and wrap your object in. If it's a still image you're not going to animate, you're done. Otherwise, make it move. Let's go back to the main comp and composite everything together. Add the window comp and the window object comp to the playing card. Add text to the card describing your object. Pre-comp it and don't forget about textures. Now, it looks something like this. Time to make it move in 3D space. Create a new null, name it control. Now make all the layers 3D and parent them to the null. Adjust the Z position of the layers so they appear in order. On the null, make a keyframe for Y rotation. You can adjust the scale as well if you want. I want my card to move from left to right, but you can make it move in any way you want. Press F9 to ease the keyframes and play with the speed graph to make the movement feel less mechanic. I want the card to quickly rotate and linger in the middle a bit and then quickly wind back. Next is animating the scale of the main object. Set a keyframe and when the card is facing you directly, scale the window object up, making it break the border. Copy the easing of the keyframes on the control knob. If you manually animated the object, ease those keyframes in the same way as well. But since I'm using a pre-rendered asset, I'll only animate the scale. My object animation already goes in reverse, so I only have to match the speed between the card rotation and the object. It's starting to look pretty good. Now, let's go to the playing card window comp and adjust the offset. We want it to match the speed of the scaling, so make keyframes at the same points and with the same easing. Now it should look just a bit more convincing as another element is moving. Before we move on to the light, I want to quickly show you how you can use camera footage instead of static images or 2D animations. Okay, let's remove the sun from our window object and add the footage. I will be using this shot of me doing a cardist remove called Water Wheel. I will adjust the comp to fit the footage as well as rename the comp to Water Wheel window object. You might have noticed that it's recorded with some movement. I did that on purpose, so it would match with the movement of the card. This is not necessary, but it does make it feel more natural. As I want only the cards as the object, I would need to cut out everything else. Luckily, technology is very useful and you can use the roto brush to cut out the footage. It does a pretty good job, but I still recommend you go through the frames and correct it by hand, especially if you're dealing with small and thin objects like cards. Using shortcuts will be very beneficial in this process. Once you have your cutout, place it into the window. Because I recorded this footage with movement, I will not make it a 3D layer. Real life is already acting as a 3D. If you don't use camera movement, just make the layer 3D like with the sun. I also want to add a border to the window. Adjust the scale to match the rotation of the card. If the object goes out of the card borders, create a mat using the white card layer. To make it go in reverse, duplicate the layer, right click, time reverse layer and place it after the first one. Adjust the keyframes for the window texture. And that's it. Last element I add is a simple spotlight. Right click, new, light, spotlight and you can play around with the settings to see what works for you. I ended up adjusting the position and point of interest. I also added keyframes to the intensity, bumping it up just a bit when the card comes closer and bringing it back down when it goes away. Now you might notice that the non-3D layer is not affected by the light. To fix that, I will add a curves effect and animate it to sync up with the rest of the composition. I also want it to feel as if the card surface is reflecting light. To do that, I will go to the playing card comp, create an adjustment layer and add the light sweep effect. This creates a line of light you can control. I will animate it to sync up with the card rotation. Set the direction to 0, change the color to fit the design of your card, adjust the width, sweep intensity and edge intensity. Now make a keyframe for center and position it on the right border of the card. Go to the position of the next frame in your control null and move the center to the left side of the card. Go to the next position and move the center back to the right. You can copy the keyframe from the start, ease them in the same way you did the control null. Play around with the light sweep settings until you find something that works for your card. I want to add the same light sweep to the text as well. Copy the adjustment layer and paste it into the text pre-comp. Adjust the center position keyframes to make it look like a uniform light moving over the card. And that's basically it. You can add different backgrounds to fit your card design. If you want to get really trippy, you can add the window textures to the background as well. You can download the project file in the description if you want to dive deeper into it. And let me know in the comments if you're having any trouble navigating it.